How can we advocate to do things differently? And how can we, as a foundation, use our resources and our networks to provide space and opportunity for Black excellence to really shine and thrive, but also demonstrate power and be in shared decision making? And so I saw this as an opportunity to be an example for other funders and other philanthropic organizations of how this shared power and this shared trust building could actually work. This was a very multi-level process, and the Community Foundation realized we needed to be in conversation with community about how do we change our grant process. To get to that, we asked the community to nominate people from the Black community who could help us redesign our grant making process.
People get used to doing things a certain kind of way, and we get locked into these historical practices and feel that, you know, to change and do something different is just perhaps not practical or feasible. And I think this proves that yes, you can be very intentional about how you give dollars out in the community. You can trust those that have proximity to those that are most impacted by societal challenges. And you can also, trust and inject a level of trust, I think, in grant making that often is lacking within the current construct of investing in communities.
And what this program was saying is that those that are, I love the word, in proximity to the issues that we're addressing should be the ones who make those decisions on behalf of their peers. And we could facilitate it, but we don't need to sit there in judgment. And that was a big piece of it.
I agreed to be a part of this process because I found my voice to be a unique voice that needed to be at the table as a young Black woman, as a Louisville native. I think that, and as someone that grew up in the Louisville community, I grew up in very much like Black spaces. So I was able to do tap and ballet under Black instructors. I was able to do Girl Scouts under Black instructors. All of these programs that are often grant funded. And I know the value of those programs. I know that what it's like when those programs stop receiving funding. And now as a professional, I've been in predicaments to where I've had to apply for grant dollars, and I know how tedious it can be, but I also know how rewarding it can be to receive the funding.
It just continues to reinforce that you have incredible leadership. You have just people, again, that have proximity and lived experience that are personally impacted by this, that we need to trust and empower to really have the opportunity to scale the solutions that they're trying to put in community.
The selection committee really thought about things that we as a foundation traditionally would not have thought about or considered when selecting the organizations. They really thought about how can this cohort work and grow together, and what does each individual organization bring into the cohort so all of these organizations will excel together.
I don't think we can say enough how the foundation opened a space.
Yes.
To say, come in here and tell us what's on your mind.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
That is rarely done.
I've, you know, gone back and charged my own team with how might we model what you all did with Community Foundation with this Racial Justice Cohort. This becomes, you know, just very insightful as we continue to transform our own grant making. And I think other foundations are also standing up and taking notice. And so I'm hopeful and expecting, not even hopeful, but very much expecting to see, you know, continued resource and investment in community that follows this frame.
Many of the assets in foundations are really assets that belong to the community and were, if not taken away, they weren't able to share with it. So we got to build the wealth. And so what we're doing here, I don't think is an act of largesse or generosity. I think it's an obligation.
This process can help cultivate that we need to listen more to the people who are in community, who are doing the work. And in doing that, as being supporters, we're helping the rest of our community to be the best that it can be, in essence, helping all of us to be the best that we can be.